If you, Aliza.
Welcome back, Remy.
Okay, we're good. Okay, I'm heard. Somebody there?
Yes.
Okay, great. Okay, so today, We will continue with Pele Yoetz. I have a few short pieces today. Mitzvah Hashem, tomorrow we will do Tfilah. Okay. So today, like I said, there's a few short pieces. So we'll see what we can cover. The first piece deals with the concept called Hakpada. Hakpada, we're familiar with the term, someone is makpid. So insistent, intransigent, a person who's very insistent or intransigent about a certain thing. So he says like this, Hakpada hi toledes hagava. The Pele Yoetz wants to say that Hakpada is a result of a person's gaiva. Minefesh vad basar. So, right, in other words, it's a byproduct. It's not something that happens in the vacuum. He wants to say that that is a natural byproduct of a person's haughtiness, that a person is very insistent that things go a certain way, and an uncompromising type of a personality, which is what its idea is a consequence of a person being a haughty person. And he continues and he says, "Mi nefesh, from his soul, vad basar, till his flesh, techaleh, it will consume the person. Ki chayiv einem chayim. The person's life will not be a life." My assumption is that because a person, not everything's going to go a person's way. It doesn't generally work that way in the world. Not in every situation are you that's basically a dictatorial type of a personality, an authoritarian type of a personality. That type of a mindset will destroy the person. Umi avos yaitse toldos, and from that will come other byproducts. Shigorim lavo lidei sina, because if a person, again, it has certain expectations that things have to go in a certain fashion, uncompromisingly that way, and that won't happen. It's not going to be a realistic expectation that every time the situation is going to be like that person. So that's going to lead to then sina. Then that's going to lead to a person's hatred towards the other person. But tacharus umachlokas, and to cause argumentation. For lashon hara, it's going to cause lashon hara. Bikahena raus rabos. In other words, you're opening up a Pandora's box over here if you're going to live with this type of an explanation. And as a result, it's going to lead from one negativity to another. Umanda kapid means shmaya. Captain Bahadei, and this is also something a very, very important thing to remember. If a person wants certain things done in a certain way, so then heaven is also going to be insistent on you. If this is the way you treat other people, that you want things to go in a certain manner, and you're uncompromising in that way, then heaven is going to be that way with you also. It's like we're going to work by the book. If this is the way you want people to relate to you, it has to be your way. So heaven, it says, well, we want things our way too, and let's see how you're doing. Let's see if you meet that criterion. If you have the highest expectations from other people, well, then heaven's going to say the same thing with you. What type of, you know, how are you meeting your requirements? Are you meeting our expectations in heaven? Kol kabel dinah, on the contrary, he brings down hamayver al midosav, someone who's able to overlook things, that even if things don't go the way he expected, and he's able to overlook it, that this is it. It's people, you know, this is people, we can do that. So maviran lo al kol pshav, so then heaven, they'll do the same thing with you. Then they'll overlook things by you as well. If you're a big enough person to understand that not every situation is going to be my way, and I'm not going to explode or respond and come down on the person, so then heaven will say the same thing with you. Since you're able to overlook things for others, heaven will overlook what your shortcomings as well. And then yishkon lebech betach, you're in a much better situation within for yourself and for everybody else involved. Vein emes, it's true. Shemidas ha'akpada, this character trait of being intransigent and being so insistent with others. Ruachi be'enosh, it is a spirit within a person, but again, he's telling us that this is a byproduct of a person's haughtiness. Umidara min habeten, umin ha'hirayon. He says this is something that we come away with from our very birth. Umisha tivo shalola hakbit klal. In other words, well, let's finish up and then we'll explain. But if someone has a nature where he's very easygoing, he's a chilled person, has a very nice, easygoing personality. Things don't get under his skin too much. He's very accepting. Zu matas elokim hi. You should know that's a gift from God. In other words, by nature, if a person, the norm is that a person is makpid. This is a person's inborn nature, because this is a test that we all, that most of the world, if not all of the world, has to go through. You have to learn to discipline yourself, to hold yourself back. That is the idea over here. And to be, and to give person a certain slack, to be overlooked, not to see everything. It's like I once heard that a person has to be half deaf and half blind, meaning that what you're not supposed to see everything, you're not supposed to hear everything. You have to let certain things just go over your head. Don't respond to everything you hear and everything you see. Don't come down on people. You have to try to not to catch everybody doing the wrong things, because everybody makes mistakes and we all have shortcomings. And if we're going to catch every time we see it, then that's going to be not a very pleasant situation. We have to be half blind and half deaf, not to hear everything a person says and not to see everything a person does. But and as he says, this is something that we're all born with, basically. And on the other hand, someone who is so easygoing, that you should know that's a gift from Hashem. Therefore, al zeh haderech b'kol hamidos, so based on this and with every other character trait that we have, every shortcoming, things that are negative in our personality and things which are forbidden, aval hein odem sholit beruach, val yedei hishtat, we have a capability to take control over here. We have to just take from our natural resources and to try to take control over it, val yedei hishtadluso, and by his efforts. Yom yom, every single day, a person has to work on it, little by little, not to get disappointed. If he has shortcomings in this area, has to work on it little by day. The machshavas tahoros, to start rethinking things. It's like Rabbi Wein gives the mashal. He says, you know, if you have a super tanker, it's going in the wrong direction. So till it turns around, it can take a long, long time. It can't turn around quickly. Right, it makes a very quick turnabout. The whole boat could capsize. It has to go very slowly. It's going to keep going in the wrong direction, but slowly, slowly, it's going to start turning little by little. So that eventually, after a while, then the boat will be able to turn itself around all the way. So that's the idea over here. Little by little, this character flaw that we have within us all. That little day by day, I'll start thinking new ways and trying to control myself, and I'll have machshavas tahoros, ushkidaso, and my constant looking over sifrei musar to read about the musar, yesh koach biyado, you have the capabilities, lahachlif midosav, one can overturn his character traits. This is what he's telling us over here. But we all know the famous story that Rabbi Yisrael Salanter said, that it's easier to learn through all of Shas than it is to change one character trait. So we have to appreciate how important it is for us, because if we don't appreciate it, then we're going to become disappointed very easily and then we'll just give it up. But we have to appreciate that it is it's crucial for us to have a life. And I was like he's saying over here, if we have such a mindset in us, our life is not a life, it's just going to eat us up. So if we appreciate the urgency of it and the importance of it, and therefore we make a solid determination to work on it, then you can actually change your midos, he's telling us, mi rabatov, you can go from negativity to positive. V'lasur mi mokshe moves, and you'll remove yourself from the death trap. V'lishmor es derech hachayim, you'll be on the road to derech hachayim. V'ktsas dvorim, ki yitein ha'ish es libo aleihem, And there are a few things that a person should put to his heart. Linatzel mimidos akpada, to try to save himself from this character trait of intransigence. Halohem ksuvim leel. I wrote earlier about this and the idea of havas reyim, how one should love another person. Ubearech gaivo, or in my piece that I wrote on gaivo, on haughtiness. So maybe Mitzvah Shem will look into that at some point. Yishma chacham veYosef lekach. You'll take from their ideas and you'll add your own. Okay, that's the first paragraph. Moving on in this. Will be Yoser, and even more so, Tzorach lezarez, shelo lahakpid al ishto. A person has to be very, very careful not to be so intransigent with one's spouse. Will mishors of people that work with him. Will be nebeso, his household, his family. Ki yetzer somach masito, because one's yetzer, which is so close to you, is constantly antagonizing him. Hesed kaful, he's working overtime and overtime again to antagonize you. She is malaroges lahakpid ma'od, to get you to be overly intransigent. But over maldaito, that these household people, that your wife, your spouse, and your children, etc., and those in close proximity to you, are not following your understandings. They're not following your what you want. They want the Yetzer Hara is always working over here to get you to explode. Because again, anything that's crucial, the Yetzer Hara wants to take away from us. Something that can be of an enormous help to us, the Yetzer Hara tries to destroy all that. Just like, you know, just like now, just let's understand. After we just went through the Kabbalah Satora. So the Yetzer Hara understood that the Jewish people during these days, after Shavuos until Shivasa Batamos, were at the highest level they ever attained. They were on the level of Adam HaRishon before the sin. There was not going to be death anymore. They had everything. They had reached the pinnacle of success. And that's why the Yetzer Hara now worked so hard to destroy all that. Because he understood that if the Kabbalah Satorah will go through, if Moshe will come down and there'll be Makabal the Torah, then that means that's it. He's off. He's finished. And therefore he worked so hard to destroy all that we had gained. So the same thing over here. In a family structure, a person has everything that he can build his whole eternity on. Building with a family and children, etc. One can make his eternity with all this. And that's why the Yetzer Hara is working so hard to destroy that connection. But if a person is truly a God-fearing person, as yikanet levavo, he will humble his heart. The Yachshav, and he'll think to himself like this. Hare ani yeludisha. I'm a human being. Kamoso, just like that other person, like my spouse, like my children, like the people who work for me. I'm the same as they are. Vimani nichpad. If I'm so honored, v'nevad mitzad mazli. In other words, I happen to have been born into a position where people are servicing me. Shechanani Hashem. Hashem has blessed me with that. With osher, with wealth, with kavod, with respect. Efshe shelagabe shemayahu nichpa mimeni. But maybe in heaven, that person is more honored than I am. Well, like it says in the pasuk, katon v'gadol, sham hu nikar. Whether a person is great or is small, in heaven they know. They know. Like it's like the Gemara in Bava Basra also. The Gemara in Bava Basra brings down that. They asked him. He said, "What did you see?" He had a he lost consciousness and went to Shemayim and he came back. And they asked him, "What did you see?" So he said, "Olam hafuch reisi. I saw an opposite world. The people that are considered so important in this world and the next world, they're on the bottom. And the people who are on the bottom over here are on the top over there." So he's saying a similar idea over here. Maybe just because in this world I'm considered something important, but maybe in Shemayim I'm not. Maybe that person's more important than I am. And you'll recognize, and it could be that the Eved is more important than the master. And if this person in this world is obligated to honor me, mitzad shemekabel hanoa, because I give him certain benefits, muetas, small ones, but whatever it is, because I give him certain benefits, there's an obligation for him to respect me, al yadi through me, or mishad tzivu habori bechvodi, or maybe because Hashem commanded this person to give me respect, like children have to respect their parents, or a wife has to respect her husband. That's what Hashem wants. Alach has kama b'kama, but how much more so? Chayev ani, how much obligated I am. Bichvod bori, I have to honor my creator. Yotzi, the one who created me. V'osi asher hediv tuvo, look what he's given me. V'gom alemi, look what benefits Hashem is constantly bestowing on me. Chosodim tovi, kindnesses upon kindnesses. Arein chekin, no end. Arein mispar, b'yosi, and I'm going to anger Hashem? And how much I anger him. Look what I do. I do so much, so many things to Hashem to cause him to anger me. And yet he still gives me these things. I don't serve Hashem to the fullest that I should. I disappoint Hashem also sometimes. I'll do things that will upset him. Woe is to me. Woe is to me if Hashem will pay me back the way I'm serving him. And we have to realize, like we mentioned earlier, the way you treat others, that's the way Hashem's going to judge you. This is what a person has to think about. And day by day, give yourself chizuk, strength, and it will get better. It will definitely get better. It will get better. You'll see that, because if you keep working on it little by little, take small steps. Another idea, this is my own thing, I don't know, you know, take it for what it's worth. Once heard from somebody, if you would know that you're being tested, and you understand that if I don't demonstrate this intransigence, I'm going to now be given $100,000, you would just sit there and smile and just let it go past you. You'd let it go past you. You understand that if I just let this go by, I'm going to get $100,000. It won't affect you. You'll just let it go by. So the same thing over here. We have to realize that in heaven, they're watching over us. And they want to see, how am I going to respond to a person that doesn't necessarily, it's not following what it's not meeting my expectations. So what do you do in that situation? So if I appreciate that, If I pass this situation, if I'm successful in this, Hashem is going to give me a new strength and a new situation in Shemayim, then it's worth everything. And this is how we have to do it little by little, day by day. It definitely takes time, but it's something that is going to make an enormous difference in my life, because I want to have a calmness in my house. I don't want to have such a tension in my closest relationship, because then physically it's going to eat up a person. But besides the spiritual, that he's mentioning the spiritual over here, it's so important to be able to have a calmness in life and a functioning life. So you want to make sure that this is something that we have to think about, all of us. We have to realize that, look what Hashem is doing for me. And if Chas v'Shalom Hashem would be upset at the way I respond, how much more so I have to do that with those that are with myself. Okay, we still have some more to this piece over here. Yeah, hopefully we'll finish this piece. Amna midas akpada, this character trait of intransigence, roi lahachzi bon neged chaveiro. But he's saying, every time, just like, once said, the person's lazy. So laziness, Hashem gave you laziness for a good reason. Because when your Yetzirah wants you to go out and do something, oh, I'm lazy, I can't do it today. We have to use these traits that we have in order to counteract the Yetzirah. So he's saying the same thing over here. If a person wants to be a makpid person, then be makpid someone else's respect. Be makpid for them. L'hakpid al kvodo. Be insistent for the honor of someone else. Lavral daito, not to go against what he wants. If this person has a certain expectation from me, then I should be makpid to follow what that person wants. Afilu daka mina daka, to the smallest details. Not for yourself, but rather for someone else. Use this trait of hakpada in order to try and fulfill other people's expectations. Ki hamitzar es chaver, because if someone will hurt someone else, ki lutzir olam malei, you hurt an entire world. Malakoy yavi elokim b'mishpat, Hashem will judge me for that. Afilu im hara kina, yeah, that's the word I think Mar brings down over here. If you smash a cockroach or something in front of someone, and a person you know is sensitive about that, then he gets disgusted by it. I feel even that is considered, Hashem will judge you about that. So you have to think about what is this person's sensitivities to, and you should follow it the whole way. I feel shalom is coming, even though you didn't intend to hurt, you didn't intend to do it, you just stepped on it. But that person has such a sensitivity that it bothered him. It's not good. And if we go into this, Tesamer Saros Basara, we will be very frightened. V'yamod al ha-mishmar k'kol habor miyodo. Anything that happens to you, v'yavakesh rachamim, we should daven me'achonin la'odim das, from Hashem who gives us an understanding. Shi'atakneu be'etzatova, to give us a clear mind thinking. Lasos hatov, to do what's good. V'hayashar be'enei Elokim v'adam, to always want to do what's good for people. In other words, if I'm going to be makpid again, be makpid for others, to try to do what they would want me to do fully. And that's using the midah of hakpada that Hashem gave us in the best way. Because sometimes we think we know what that person would want. No, it's going to hurt the person. Just because, there's very often we tend to put on others what we like. We think, well, if we like it, he's going to like it too. But that's not necessarily so. Don't you had good intention, but that's not necessarily what it means. It's because you think it's good, but not necessarily does that person want it. But call Orum Yasa Badas, if you're an intelligent person, you'll think it out. For Yivrach Ma'od Mikol Devar Sheyesh Lochus, you'll stay far away from anything. Miniela, even from a thousandth, Shema Ruach Abrios Nochi Menu, that maybe they won't like it. Maybe the person doesn't want it. V'chol Odim Yechoshdom Kilistim. Right, this is the famous idea over here. You have to live with a certain suspicion, but you have to honor them as well. You always have to have this balance and to know when and how to play that out. This is such an important concept that he's bringing out over here. That if a person wants to do good, Hashem is not going to hold back. If a person is truly sincere and wants to do the right thing, then you can be guaranteed that Hashem is not going to orphan us. He's not going to leave you behind and not give you opportunities to go in that direction. If I want to serve Hashem well and I want to live my life as an Eved Hashem, then Hashem is definitely going to send people and put me in the best possible ways where I can definitely succeed in that. So you mean Hashem, you'll get help from heaven. Shiruach habros nechaymana, the people will respect you and they'll like you. And you'll find favor in God's eyes and in people's eyes. Now is the last paragraph over here. How much more so? We have to always try to be as careful as we can to bring out a Kiddush Hashem. To do the mitzvahs to our fullest capabilities and to do good things, and to even try to go above and beyond what's demanded of us. It's like once heard from someone else, we asked to Hashem on Rosh Hashanah, we're like avodim and kabonim, we're like children, we're like avodim. If an eved, if a master asks his eved to bring him a cup of coffee, so the eved will bring him a cup of coffee. If a father asks his child to please bring him a cup of coffee, so on the plate it'll be a cookie. The father didn't ask him to bring a cookie, but you know that your father likes cookies, so you'll do that too. You don't have to be told to do that. That's chassidus. You know what the person wants, even though the person didn't ask for it, you'll do it anyway. If you're an eved, if your relationship with Hashem is an eved, I just do exactly what I'm told. I'm working by the book. Then I'll do what I'm told, and that's the end of it. But that's a different one. That's a It's a low level relationship. It's an avid relationship. A person wants to be like a child, a true deep connection with Hashem, then you'll do like that. If Hashem has a certain request from me, then Hasidus will tell me, go above and beyond. If you know your father likes a cookie, you'll put the cookie on the plate too. Malasos nachas ruach le'yotzer, you'll bring nachas to Hashem. V'livroch min aveira, you'll distance yourself from an aveira. V'laval dikduke mitzvahs, and not to follow all the details of mitzvahs, because details just show the relationship that I have. I'm careful about every detail. I'm not trying to do a sloppy job. It's not pass or fail. I'm looking to do the best I can. Afilu dakin shibai, and even the smallest details. Kigodol kvodo, because how great is Hashem's honor. The godlo chavoseno, how enormous is our responsibility. Because if we just think about what Hashem does for us and all the details, all the small things that Hashem looks out for us, then that should naturally bring out a feeling in us to try to do also, to pay back in all with all details that I could do also. Adin cheker, lavod, kol nafshenu, will serve Hashem with all of our soul. We'll give it 100%. We're not looking just to, like I say, get by. We're totally committed, like the Jews said, Nasa v'nishman, by Kabbalah Satorah. It was a complete commitment. B'kol levavenu lasos nachas ruach liyotreinu, to give nachas, v'shelo ligram shum tsar, never to cause any pain, or pagam, or any blemish, l'mala in shemayim chas v'shalom. Hashrei ish yoreyes Hashem. Fortunate is someone who has the awe of Hashem. Yeyer mishnasu, he'll wake himself up. V'leya nirdam, he will not be lazy. Kizek kol odem, because this is what defines my life, my connection to Hashem, and I'll try to work on it to its fullest extent. Okay, gentlemen, perfect. So we did one piece. Okay. Mirz Hashem, we'll do those other pieces some other time, but we did this piece on Akpada. And Mirz Hashem, tefillah tomorrow, Bezrat Hashem. Are there any questions or we're good? Okay. Okay, then. If there's no response, I hope Mirz Hashem will pick up tomorrow then.
Thank you very much.
Rabbi, thank you.
Thank you, Rabbi.
You're welcome.
Yesterday.
Thank you, Rabbi.
Okay, Baruch Hashem. Thank you. Okay, have an amazing day, boys. Everything should be matzliach.
Okay.
Very good. All the best. Take care.